So basically, we are a biosignal processing company, and currently we are focused on building bionic limbs for upper limb amputees. So these are robotic devices for people who do not have a hand, which are controlled by muscle and nerve signals.
Okay. So is this it here?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So what's unique about this prosthetic versus others?
So we are really focused on building a low-cost, high-efficacy device, which is to reduce the price point without compromising on the efficiency. We are also focused on reducing the weight of the prosthesis and making it more intuitive to control for the user.
Okay. How does the user control it?
The user controls it using sensors which are located on the skin of the user, on the muscles which are available in the hand. So by making a normal grip mode like a flexion or extension or closing a hand, our product recognizes the gesture that the user wants to do and does this particular gesture.
Oh, wow. Okay. So you say it's low cost. How much would it cost?
So we are focused on selling it to the prosthetic centers at a price point somewhere between $7,500 to $8,500.
Okay.
So average $8,000. But the prosthetic centers then do the fabrication, fitting, and training of the and provide it to the user forward. So
okay.
Essentially, we are a B2B model.
Okay. I'm admittedly not super familiar with the prosthetics market. How much do prosthetics normally cost?
In general, the state-of-the-art devices, which are the current leaders in the market, cost somewhere between $25,000 to $100,000. These are multi-action hands, and there are low-cost, cheap hands which only have a single action, which cost somewhere around $3,000 to $8,000.
Okay. What stage are you at now?
So we are actually looking for the product launch in Q1 of 2020. We are currently in the medical certification phase, and we are conducting clinical testings and clinical evaluation, and looking forward to the launch.
Okay. Would that be in the US and Europe, or just Europe, or where are you planning on launching?
So initially, we are going to start with our launch in India and Poland. Then we are going to expand into the Asian market, Middle Eastern, and the European market, and finally to the American market as well.
Okay. So what kind of grips can it do? What can it do functionally?
So we provide up to 12 different grip modes with an option of customizing two more grip modes for specific activities by the user. So it can do a power grip, which is useful for handing a bottle, or a tripod grip, which is useful for precise manipulation, a key grip for a key or a card, something like that.
Okay. So what's been the most challenging thing so far in making this?
So product development has definitely not been easy. Everything needs to be small in size. It needs to be integrated and fit perfectly. Plus, it's a medical device, so the quality management system needs to be really strong. We need to make sure that we adhere to the rules and the regulations. That's been a challenge, but we are trying to move forward into that. Apart from that, there is also a change in medical device regulations as of now, from the old directives to the new medical device regulations. So going through that framework is also something which is a bit challenging, I guess.
Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.